We've been working here at the stabling yard for about 4 months now, on and off since November, excavating the remnants of an Aboriginal site in what looks to be an intact sand dune, part of the Botany sand sheet that extends across the eastern suburbs. And what we've been doing is uncovering a rather dense and significant site of stone artefacts. We're excavating them by hand over here and then transporting them to the sieves, where team members will sieve everything and collect the artefacts at the end for counting and processing. So what we have is evidence of both the raw material, which is unworked, and some evidence of the process through which the material is worked to create tools, including completed tools, as well as the debitage, or the material that is discarded in the process of making a tool. To date, we've excavated roughly 109 square meters of the site, and in that area we've got approximately 22,000 artifacts. It's an unprecedented quantity of worked material for this area. Sydney CBD is quite disturbed due to the level of historical development in the area, and particularly the eastern suburbs is relatively misunderstood or not well understood. So this is quite significant scientifically in understanding how the Aboriginal community used this landscape. And the types of material that they were using and working and where they were camping and living.
It's very important because this is one of the first sites that been done in Sydney itself on a full-scale excavation, and it brought forward this unique stone which no one ever, most archaeologists don't know where it comes from. But I'm a fourth generation Darug descendant. We're trying to get the part of this project put in the school curriculum, so we come in for the Aboriginal studies. Not many children or people out in the public knows whatever happens on a site. They never see the stone artefacts and tools that comes out. By doing this Aboriginal cultural heritage assessment work, I'm making well the Darug name, that be not forgotten.
So the next step for us will be to analyse the artefacts and the geomorphology, the study of the sands and the deposition of the material here, and then look at that in relation to previous sites that people have identified across Sydney and see if there's a relationship between them and see if we can identify a bit more about how this landscape works.